property under the hammer, I've headed south to Kent.
We're in historic Rochester today, one of the Medway towns in Kent. Charles Dickens, the famous author, used to live nearby, and he based many of his novels in this area.
I'm here to view a property right on the High Street, and it's in a local conservation area.
We're here to see a commercial property today. This four-storey building. Until recently, it was used as a health spa. But as you can see, it's on a very busy intersection, so there's no parking. But we are really close to the train station. It's just over there. Let's have a look inside.
Its guide price at auction was £160,000 to £170,000.
Well, I was expecting a very clean and clinical reception area. But I've got to say, it's more like a rundown office with no character at all inside. Now remember, this is a conservation area, so you would be restricted with what you could do to the frontage with regards to the windows and putting signs up. There's a couple of floors upstairs that I've got to investigate, so let's have a look around. So up here on the first floor is the sauna and shower area. You've got the steam room through there, lots of toilets around here. But it's all just a little bit grim, isn't it? But you've got to forget what it looks like and think about what it could be. Now, it's a freehold commercial premises, which means if you set up a business here, you have long-term security, and that is key for any investor.
You might need some of the steam from the sauna to clean up this place. Upstairs on the second floor, the decor's not much better. The lilac room off the landing is a good size, but it could be even bigger if you remove the false ceiling. There's also a narrow kitchen on this floor, plus another area for the boiler, full of pipes and hot water tanks. The building still has its original crittle metal windows, so you can really hear the traffic noise. But as the property's in a conservation area, you may have to keep them. Well, three down and one floor to go. The one right at the top of the property is just two interconnecting rooms.
As a health and beauty spa, this had D2 business classing, but it had a restriction, so it's only ever been used as a spa and not for other D2 use, such as a cinema or a dance venue or a bingo hall. But before that, it was a news agent with residential accommodation up here. And so hopefully it wouldn't be too difficult to get the planning permission to convert the other floors up here into residential. I think it'll be quite easy to convert this back into flats, although you would really have to think about the internal layout up here. And this floor up here in the eaves would be classed as a studio flat.
So we've got four rather shabby floors here, but lots of potential. And there's also one very small bonus at the back of the property.
You can hardly call this outside space a garden, but the interesting thing is, if you do want to convert this property into flats, then you've got a separate rear entrance, which is ideal. It gives you more options when developing.
I invited a local estate agent along to take a look and try and gauge the potential for this former spa. What options does this property expert see here?
It's a really good property to buy, and I think it has a lot of uses. I think possibly there won't be any possibility of turning the ground floor to residential, but they will keep that as some sort of shop or office use. But I think the parts of the above could be made into a nice flat in this area.
Knowing the local area, how many flats could you feasibly fit upstairs?
I think with the layout, you could possibly either have one very large flat on two levels, or alternatively two, perhaps one bedroom flats on each level.
One thing any buy-to-let investor wants to know is how much rental income the property could generate. What are the rental returns likely to be?
I think the commercial rent, if you were to have this as the ground floor as an office location, you would probably be looking at an average of around £100 a week, probably about £5,200 a year. For the flats, totally different, depending on how the accesses are. But I think the one bedroom flats, if you had two of those, you'd get at least £550 per calendar month for those. I think the easiest thing for this property is to sell it as one block, because the access is probably a little too difficult to sell the flats off individually. I think on a good market, you would probably be looking, once all the work had been renovated and the flats had been done, somewhere between £250,000 and £300,000 for it.
This property is in a very central location, great for commuters. You're just minutes from the train station, and it offers plenty of options. It could stay as a purely commercial premises, or it could be converted completely into residential and made into small flats. But did it attract the bidders at auction? Let's find out.
Let's move on into number 112, which is 206 High Street, Rochester. Good sized premises is 4 stories of accommodation. Lots of potential here. Where are you starting on this one? Guided at 160, 170. Starting at 160, £160,000. Starting at 150 then. At 150, on 50 I'm on the way. 150. At £150,000 I've got on the left hand side. 152 then. 152 I've got. 154, 154, 154 and 6. All those premises in Rochester and we're looking for just £156,000. 156 I've got now, 158 I've got, and 160 now make it, at 160, all done at £158,000. No, we're a little bit short, but come and talk to us.
The rundown health spa in Rochester didn't reach its reserve price and was withdrawn from the auction. But Spencer, a local estate agent and property developer, managed to make a deal afterwards. I met up with him back at the property to find out more.
I had actually made a pre-auction offer on the property.
Of how much?
Of £160,000, which the vendor turned down because we were quite close to the auction. And then at the room, I could see the bidding slowing down, and it slowed down to about £157,000. The final bid was actually £158,000. And I approached the auctioneer after the end of the auction and tied up the deal at £160,000.
Spencer, why did you want to buy this?
Well, my company is currently trading about 300 metres away. My lease runs out in about 6 months' time, so it's great timing. Hopefully by the time the work's done, I'll be ready to move straight over.
Now, to use it as an estate agency, that requires A2 usage, doesn't it?
That's correct, yes.
Have you spoken to the local town planners?
I have, and it's a really tricky situation because Medway Council are quite reluctant to grant A2 use specifically. But I think given this building's history and given its previous use, I'd like to think that it's definitely an upgrade to what it was used as previously.
But what if you don't get the usage? Do you have a plan B?
The plan B is to appeal. and plan C would be ultimately, unfortunately, to rent out the commercial premises to something else.
Now, I used to have flats above a long time ago. You're hoping to convert it back into flats. What are you going to do in terms of all the layout? Because it's rather small in some spaces, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. Well, basically, the floor that we're on now is going to become the bathroom, the open plan lounge, diner in an L shape. And then upstairs, we're going to create 2 double bedrooms. So the space will actually work really well with the property.
Squeezing 2 double bedrooms up in this roof space might be a challenge. This will be the biggest refurbishment project he's undertaken so far. But, of course, it will all depend on the planners.
And how long do you think it will take you before all of this is up and running?
Optimistically, I'd say about 3 months. But knowing what builders are like, and we've got to work with the local planners and the local council, who are currently quoting like a 12-week turnaround, I think 3 months is possibly optimistic.
Good luck with this. And let's hope you can turn downstairs into an estate agency. So good luck with the A2 usage.
Thank you.
Be good to see it when it's done.
Thank you very much.
Well done.
Thank you.
I just hope Spencer's finances don't vaporise when renovating his former health spa. Because there's an awful lot of work to do here. We're now returning to this busy road junction in Rochester, Kent, where this 4-storey commercial property was bought for £160,000 by local estate agent Spencer. The property had been a health spa. But Spencer planned to relocate his estate agency business to the ground and first floors, converting the rest of the building into a 2-bedroom flat. 18 months later, we've come back. I know there's been a property slump, but the estate agent's window hasn't got any houses in it. Inside, the offices of the former health spa now look more like a builder's supply shop than an estate agency. On the first floor, the sauna, showers and various cubicles have gone, and one large, light, open space has been created. Right at the top of the property, the former attic room has been scrubbed clean and refurbished. It all looks great, but what happened to Spencer's ambitious plans? Didn't he want to create a two-bedroom flat on the two top floors above the estate agents?
We were originally going to have a two-bedroom property because we felt the size of the property was such that it warranted two bedrooms. That idea, unfortunately, wasn't looked upon favourably. So eventually it's become a one-bedroom property, which I think, actually, I'm really happy with. It's a great size and the layout works really well.
The floor directly above the shop, which used to be the health club sauna, is now going to be an office for the estate agents. The flat, accessed from the rear of the building, occupies the two top floors above.
This is the first floor of the flat. We've got the bathroom just down there and the stairs up to the main bedroom. This is the main living room space. We've still got the floor covering to do. And over in the kitchen, there's going to be a wooden laminate flooring and some tiles for the kitchen to, between the units. It's turned out really well. I'm very happy with it. It's much bigger than I'd hoped. And also, it's really light. There's double windows in the front, so it's a really nice, light living space.
Replacing the original metal windows wasn't straightforward because the building's in a conservation area. This meant using modern crittle versions with double glazing, which are expensive. But it wasn't just the noise from the traffic Spencer was trying to keep out.
Because of the location of the premises, fairly close to a main road, but also a busy junction, it falls in what's known as an air quality management area. And that means we've had to adhere to very strict guidelines to make sure that the tenants or the people that are going to be living here are safe in terms of the air that they're breathing. That's involved installing a specialist air extraction machine, and really it's something for potential developers, I think, to look out for. It's something that although I've been in the business for 15 years, it's something I've been completely unaware of and wasn't aware of until I bought this project.
And the issues didn't stop there. Spencer's using the shop for his estate agency and the floor above as an office. That meant meeting strict building regulations to deaden both the sound and heat transfer between the business and flat above.
This is the ground floor of our office space. We're going to have a main desk and reception seating area here. We're going to use some very funky contemporary furniture. It's going to be a really nice environment for people to come into. I think often with estate agents, people are quite daunted about coming in, but we're going to try and make this as welcoming and as friendly as possible.
It's been 18 months since we first saw the property. Spencer paid $160,000 for the building, but with those planning delays, the air quality issues and the soundproofing, has he managed to keep to his budget?
I originally said, I believe, about 30 to 35 for the budget. We're now currently at about the early 50s. The reason the budget has gone over so much, in main, due to the cost of the extra windows, the cost of the air extraction system, and the sound deadening that we've had to do.
Well, Spencer's one local estate agent. Time to see what two others will make of his new office and one-bed flat.
I think they've got a very good shop front, and once they get their displays in with their lighting, that is going to look really professional.
I mean, prime location for commercial business because it's a very busy road. You're going to have the cars passing by, you're going to have the pedestrians walking by. Not many flats around here are on different levels, so maybe a little bit of an advantage, something different.
Different indeed, and I'm sure it would get a lot of interest being so close to the town centre. How much could this property expect to achieve on the rental market?
Rental for the one-bedroom flat would be £550 to £575 per calendar month.
I would think we'd be looking round about £650 per calendar month.
I thought the agent which said £650 is pretty much on the money, where we'd probably achieve a little bit more than that. The other agent is obviously way out.
Of course, the flat isn't finished yet, so maybe that's why there's a disparity between what the estate agents and Spencer think it's worth. Remember, Spencer is an estate agent too. What's the value of the whole property now? The commercial space and the flat? Spencer paid £160,000 for the building, and so far, he's spent just over £50,000 doing it up.
The whole of this building to be sold in today's market, I would estimate it at £250,000.
I think in this current market, to sell the whole building as it stood, I'd be looking at somewhere around about £250,000 to £275,000 for the whole building.
Potentially around £40,000 to £65,000 gross profit, minus the usual expenses. How does that sound?
I'm quite happy with the evaluation you gave for the building. It's a little bit less than I'd expect for it as a whole. But yeah, it's more or less in keeping with kind of where I see it.
The refurbishment's taking longer than Spencer anticipated, but what a transformation. Has he got any tips to pass on to anyone who's planning a similar refurbishment?
The best advice I could give to developers really is do your homework. There's stuff that I've encountered here that I have never really encountered before, so really you can never research too much.
Good advice for any would-be property developers, buying under the hammer or not.